Okay, so now once we get into writing more complex code, at some point you're going to need to be able to say, when this happens, do this. When something else happens, react differently. So that's why we need to be able to handle conditions inside of our code. Basically, you'll need the ability to react differently and take different actions based on what's happening. So one of the more common situations, in Canada, we have all sorts of different tax levels depending on which province you live in within the country. In the US, it depends on which state you live in. And it also depends on the price. Actually, if you're buying fast food at a restaurant in Canada, if anything costs less than $1, you don't pay any tax on it. So when we're calculating tax, we actually say if the price is over a dollar or equal to a dollar, then we charge a certain amount of tax. So in Python, I can handle that by adding an if statement. And you'll notice a bit of syntax here. You'll see the if statement, if, that's fairly obvious. If my price is greater than or equal to $1, then I'm going to take the following actions. Now, a couple of things to watch out for. There's always a colon at the end of your condition. That is Python-specific syntax. And the indentation here, it's not an accident that the word tax is moved over to the right here by about by four spaces. And it is by four spaces, not a tab. Though if you're using Visual Studio Code, it'll auto-correct that for you, so you can get away with using a tab in Visual Studio Code. But try to get in the habit of making four spaces. And anything that is four spaces in will only be executed if the price is greater than or equal to $1. Now, I'm using a greater than or equal to symbol here. There's different symbols we use depending on the condition we're looking for. I might say greater than, less than, greater than or equal to, less than or equal to. The two most important ones, which do vary from programming language to programming language, is equal to would be equal sign. And the not equal to in Python is an exclamation mark equal or bang equal, depending on the term you prefer to use. Now, we can also add a default action using an else statement. That's a way of saying, if this condition is met, set the tax to 7%. Else, so if it's anything else, do the following. So if the price is not over a dollar, the rules in Canada state, if the cost is over a dollar, you pay a tax of 7%, what we call our service tax. Otherwise, you don't pay the tax. So I can use that with an else statement. Again, always remembering that colon. I constantly forget that when I'm writing my code and have to correct that with the syntax error, just as you were learning syntax errors from Christopher. And again, you have to indent by four spaces the lines you want executed if that happens. The indentation really does change execution. I could actually write this exact same code a different way. I basically want to say calculate the tax and then print the tax out. So here I say if the tax price is over a dollar, set the tax to 7 and then print it. Otherwise, set the tax to 0 and print it. Or I could just say if the price is over a dollar, set the tax to 7, otherwise set it to 0. And when I'm all done evaluating the correct value of the tax, then go and print the tax out. Both of these will do exactly the same thing. Which one should you use? I like the one on the right. It's a little bit more elegant, not having the print statement repeating. But if it's more confusing for you, there's nothing wrong with the code on the left. Now, be careful when you're comparing strings. They'll get you into trouble. So if you run this code, and I'm just trying to see if somebody's a Canadian or not, I ask what country somebody's from, and they type in Canada, and I say if the country is equal to, remembering that double equal sign means is equal to, Canada, then print, oh look, a Canadian. And obviously I set country to Canada, but comes back and gives me the, no, you are not from Canada. It did not evaluate the country. What went wrong? String comparisons are case sensitive. So when you're saying, is this string equal to this string, if one's in uppercase letters and one's in lowercase letters, then Python's going to say, that's not a match. So how do I fix that? We've got to think back to, wow, the module we did a little while ago on string functions. There's a function we can use that will convert a string to lowercase or to uppercase. So what we can do is we can take the value they give us, convert that to lowercase, and then compare that to the word Canada, all in lowercase letters. So now, when someone types in a value, doesn't matter what they type in, I'll convert it to lowercase before I do the comparison. And that will fix my error. So this is a great example of a runtime error that can occur and a way I can address that and fix that with my code. So conditions are very important and allow us to our code to react to different situations. So let's go take a look at these examples in some code before we move on to more complex types of if statements.